Well, today is the International Day for the Elimination of Racial Discrimination. And as part of our coverage, we look at a group that wants to break down barriers with words. They hail from a country reeling from war. Sri Lankans Without Borders is what they call themselves, and they're holding a reading benefit series beginning tomorrow that aims to educate and help people here and a world away. Kumaran Nadeshan is with the organization. He's also the lead organizer of the benefit series, and he spoke with Sudha Krishnan recently about the event and its message.
Kumaran, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I do want to talk about the reading series Samadhana 2012, but before we get to that, I want to get a sense of who Sri Lankans Without Borders are.
Okay, well, that's actually a much more challenging question than it seems, since we are trying to find out what Sri Lankans Without Borders is on a day-to-day basis. The way I would describe Sri Lankans Without Borders is really it's an informal network of young Canadians of Sri Lankan heritage who were either born in Canada or brought up in Canada. And for us, it was a way to engage in a different kind of dialogue and build a different kind of platform to promote truth and reconciliation and really having very honest dialogues with each other.
Well, what do you mean by a different kind of dialogue?
Well, I think it's not a secret, as you may know, Sudha, that the Sri Lankan community in Canada is very fragmented.
Between the
Sinhalese and the Tamils, and let's not forget the Muslims and the Burghers as well. And we've carried over a lot of that animosity from Sri Lanka over to Canada. And for us, we don't see why that should be the case. It is possible to stand with each other and to address issues both in the community in Canada and in Sri Lanka together. And it is really to build on that and create a platform where we can have different communities come together and work towards solidarity and acknowledgement.
Because this series, it comes at a time where there's a lot of debate. Some members of the community here or internationally, whether or not things are getting better in Sri Lanka post-war, and I'm sure there are a lot of opinions on that. So what do you hope to accomplish with this reading series?
Well, three things really, Sudha. The way I would describe it is, one, it's to celebrate really amazing Sri Lankan writing that is going on in Canada and the U.S. Growing up Sri Lankan, I read, R.K. Narayan's and V.S. Naipaul's and the Salman Rushdie's. It was very hard for me sometimes to know that are there good Sri Lankan authors out there, and gradually I did find a lot more where that came from. But it's to show the generation that is coming behind us that, look, writing as a profession or as a vocation is very viable, and we have great role models in the community who write with passion and who are getting very famous as a result of that.
And I'm sure have lots to write about.
Oh, absolutely. And a lot of them write about what it means to be Sri Lankan, what it means to be growing up Sri Lankan in the diaspora and to go back and forth, and the experiences of the diaspora, whether it is Tamil or Sinhalese or Muslim or Burger. And for us to showcase that great output in writing is terribly exciting.
I'm curious to know, I mean, you were talking about the Sri Lankan Sinhalese community and the ethnic Tamil community possibly divided. I'm just wondering, have you noticed a difference between young Sri Lankans, no matter which ethnicity they came from, years ago when people were arriving during the war, and now a difference in terms, are we getting a sense that things are better, relations are better, they're able to live a better life here, and in terms of even just relating to each other?
Well, I certainly hope so, Sudha, because I think I didn't grow up in Canada. I came here only 10 years ago, and for the most part, I did not grow up with Tamils, and coming to Toronto was my really first big introduction or interaction with the Tamil community, which I was very excited about. But I was also taken aback by the fact that the Tamil community here does not really interact much with the Sinhalese community or the Muslim community or the Burger community, which I think it's a terrible shame, because some of the struggles as first generation immigrants to Canada are very common. And so I had friends who were Sinhalese, and we socialized, but we never had the tough conversations. We never had the courageous conversations. Mm-hmm. And I think that that is still very much true, even in the younger generation growing up now, that they are all happy to hang out and talk and drink arak and drink and dance to baila. But when it comes to issues of Sri Lanka and geopolitics and what that identity means, whether to be Tamil or Sinhalese, they're still very hands-off. And either they sort of ignore the elephant in the room or they veer to the extremes where they either talk just about one kind of ideology or they say, like, you know what, we don't want to have those kinds of conversations. So for us at SLWB, it's to get away from that and to say, look, this is a safe, inclusive space where your experiences, no matter what they are, whether it's Tamil, Sinhalese, Muslim, or Burger, are all valid. Mm-hmm. Your struggles are all valid, but come to the table and talk about it.
So other than the reading series, which exposes members of the community to all sorts of opportunities, perhaps become inspired. Part of it, you're also giving back. Explain a bit about that.
Well, yes. I mean, the reading series is very important in sort of celebrating great writing of Sri Lankan Canadians and Sri Lankan Americans. But it's also an opportunity for us to recognize that it doesn't stop there, that we need to find a way to give back to the community that has really preserved our identity in Canada. And so we decided that we would use the series to raise funds for two organizations. One is Frontier College, which does really amazing work in delivering literacy programs for children in Aboriginal communities in Northern Canada. So we are giving back to yet another disadvantaged community, this time in Canada. And the other organization that we'll be donating the proceeds to is Room to Read, which is an international literacy organization that also does work in Sri Lanka, including the North and East, in places like Manara and so on.
And if people want more information, they can check the website.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you. Well, Kumaran Adesan, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.